subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson.
Welcome to another lesson. In this class, we are going to learn about transport of carbon dioxide. Transport of carbon dioxide from tissues to the alveoli. So it occurs by three ways. So first, in dissolved state in plasma. So in the dissolved state in plasma. So in plasma, carbon dioxide reacts with H2O and forms carbonic acid. So this reaction is a very slow reaction, so that only 7% of carbon dioxide is transported by this method. Second process or second way is as carbamino compounds. 20 to 25% of carbon dioxide is transported in this way. In this reaction, in this process, carbon dioxide reacts with the amino group of the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a conjugated protein, so it contains amino acids and amino group. So CO2 reacts with the amino group of hemoglobin and forms carbamino hemoglobin. So the reaction is carbon dioxide plus, this is the amino group, NH2 is the amino group, so this is the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin contains amino group, so this amino group reacts with carbon dioxide and forms carbamino hemoglobin, HbNHCOO-, and liberates H+ ions. So not only carbamino hemoglobin, carbon dioxide also reacts with amino groups of other proteins which are present in the plasma. But this is the major one which is formed in the blood. So and the third and the important method is as bicarbonates. Carbon dioxide is transported as bicarbonate. 70% of carbon dioxide is transported through RPC in the form of bicarbonates. So carbon dioxide partial pressure is very high at the tissue level. At the tissue levels, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is very high. So the carbon dioxide enters into the hemoglobin, enters into the RBC. So this is the RBC. So carbon dioxide at tissues where partial pressure is very high, and then it enters into the RBC. Inside the RBC, it reacts with the water and forms carbonic acid. So here carbonic acid is formed, and also in plasma carbonic acid is formed. But the difference is, in plasma this reaction is very slow, but in RBC the reaction is very fast due to the presence of one enzyme which is known as carbonic anhydrase. Due to the presence of this enzyme in the RBC, the reaction is very quick. That's why 70% of carbon dioxide is transported as bicarbonates. So the formed carbonic acid H2CO3 is again split into hydrogen ion and bicarbonate ions. So here hydrogen ion and bicarbonate ions. These are reversible reactions. So forward reaction occurs and the backward reaction occurs depending upon the conditions. At tissue level, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is very high. That's why carbon enters into the RBC and forms carbonic acid, and it again splits into H+ and HCO3- ions. One important property of RBC plasma membrane. So this is the plasma membrane of the RBC. So it is permeable only to the anions. Anions means negatively charged ions are known as anions. So it is permeable to anions. That's why anions can move in and out of the RBC. They can move outside into plasma or enter in again into RBC. So this is the property which is useful for the bicarbonate ion. The formed bicarbonate ions, as it is anion, it moves outside into plasma to compensate the electric balance. As the one anion comes out of the RBC, so another anion should enter into the RBC. So that anion is the chloride anion. So that process is known as chloride shift. To compensate the electric balance, exchange of chloride and bicarbonate ions between RBC and plasma occurs. That is known as chloride shift or Hamburger's shift or Hamburger's phenomenon. So this is very important for your exam. examination point of view. So these reactions, one enzyme is required, that is the carbonic anhydrase enzyme is essential. So the H plus ions, if the H plus ions are free, then the pH value may decrease. So the medium becomes acidic, but the blood has a pH value 7.4. So to maintain the 7.4 pH value, hemoglobin combines with the hydrogen ion and forms acid hemoglobin, HHB, acid hemoglobin. So it acts as a buffer. So hemoglobin acts as a buffer and reduces the acidity or falling of the pH value. So this is at the tissue levels. Tissue levels where partial pressure of carbon dioxide high, partial pressure of oxygen is low. So that's why the oxygen from this. So when hydrogen ions bind with the Hb, hemoglobin, then the hemoglobin loses the affinity towards the oxygen and oxygen will be liberated. That oxygen goes into the tissues. So due to the formation of acid hemoglobin, the combining capacity of hemoglobin with oxygen reduces and the oxygen is liberated from RBC into the tissues. So that's like that oxygen is transported to the tissues and carbon dioxide enters into the RBC. So this blood goes to the alveoli. At alveoli, the partial pressure of oxygen is very high. At alveoli means lungs. So partial pressure of oxygen is very high and partial pressure of carbon dioxide is very low. These type of conditions, the bicarbonate ions which are present in the plasma again enters into the RBC. So this is the anion, they can move inside and outside the RBC. So the bicarbonate ions enters into the RBC and chloride ions comes out of the RBC. And also, as the partial pressure of oxygen is very high, hemoglobin, acid hemoglobin, liberates H plus ions and combines with the oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin. So the liberated H plus ions, hydrogen ions, combines with the bicarbonate ion and forms carbonic acid. So this carbonic acid is again dissociates into carbon dioxide and H2O. Dissociates into carbon dioxide and H2O. As the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is very low at alveoli, so the carbon dioxide moves out from the RBC. Likewise, the carbon dioxide is transported from tissues to alveoli, and from alveoli the carbon dioxide is removed outside. So this is the transport of carbon dioxide. So I think all of you understand the process. In this you have to remember one thing: the enzyme carbonic anhydrase, chloride shift, and the reversible reactions which occur at the tissue level and at the alveolar level.
Thank you very much for listening the lesson. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon.